ever asked in PGI Chandigarh. Then coming to the arterial blood pressure, beautiful question this is. Whenever you are monitoring arterial BP, doctor, you should be careful about how is the size of the cuff. If the size of the cuff is small, a fat retired nurse has come as your patient, doctor, you are using the one which you use for thin emaciated student nurse ke liye jo istemal karte hai, usko you are using it for the retired HOD of nursing. So kya ho jata hai? If you use a smaller cuff, BP will become higher recorded. That's the point. What is the effect of standing on systolic and diastolic BP? Whenever you are standing, there is a decreased venous return. Decreased venous return in turn will cause stimulation of your baroreceptors. And typically they will cause fall of systolic BP. That in turn will stimulate your baroreceptors. And that will increase the diastolic BP. So standing, what is the ultimate effect? Fall of SBP and rise of the DBP is what you have to ultimately remember. ECF versus ICF, what is the fundamental difference between the two? I told you, no, intracellular, extracellular fluids, any entrance you go, you don't forget. Every Friday, meet the teacher session, evening 5:30 to 8. Sometimes I'll come little later, 5:40, 5:45. Have a talk with your other classmates, because pura din ghar mein baith ke akele padhne mein kya maza hai. Thoda yahan hai to doston se mil sakte ya you can have a little chat. So that is the idea. But you religiously attend the next 20 Fridays free classes, right? Hum chai bhi pilayenge, huh? So once you finish 10 PGI papers, 10 previous AIMS papers, you will recognize, are entrance yahi hai kya? Isse jyada nahi hoga kya? Kind of a feeling you will get. But you should attend. That's what I am trying to tell you. Okay? Because ultimately story will be same. Topics will be more or less same. Except 20-30% variation. Pahle baar padhne mein thoda tension rehta. Even my son who is going for engineering entrance, I gave the same formula to him. You don't do any special preparation. Engineering means nowadays they are inviting and giving you Bharat Ratna and asking you to please join us. If you join only, we will give you bravery award, they are saying. So, uske liye bhi tension ka hai? Ek jamane mein engineering mein seat aana bole to, it is like a big dream. Right? So, I told only last 15 years question papers, 15 into 200 questions, 3000 questions of the previous engineering entrance, ek bar dekhe to aa jata. So, first 7-8 papers once, he and another 3 to 4 lazy friends of him are there. Lazy means they are otherwise Facebook, social media, everything, they are too good. Life is miserable to do same mathematics trigonometry. So, first 5-6 papers they karne ke baad, they are finding same IUPAC nomenclature, same sulfur group family, first group transitional metals, same things are repeating. So, that's the reason what I am telling you. But what you, why you won't do that by yourself, I will tell you. You will think, let me become so good and then start doing PGI papers or doing AIMS papers. That good, best state doesn't come, doctor. Like marriage, if you are, you can only be good after 30-40 years of marriage, that is only a proof. Otherwise, every day you will become good in the morning, bad in the evening, best in the night. So, the transition keep on happening like a circadian rhythm. So, don't wait for tomorrow. Let me tell you. Solve the past 10 papers of PGI, AIMS, must use your common sense. You will, that is the best formula for success. So, doctor, high sodium, because it is the ECF ion, cation, high chloride, ECF, ICF will have equal osmolarity, otherwise water will keep running here and there. It should be equal, right? Then what is the, where are the calcium sensing receptors? important for calcium reabsorption. Proximal, distal, loop of Henle, enterocyte, everywhere you have all these structures, you are having calcium sensing receptors. By this, what did you sense? Two questions came on calcium, na? So, Ganang bolke ek old book tha, physiology mein. Usme do pages, endocrine physiology mein, calcium PTH, calcitonin, calcitriol ke baare mein rehta. Jara shaam mein ek chai peete huye, Mukesh ki gaana sunte huye, aap ek baar revision karo, ho jata. Because that will definitely reward you. What are sphingolipidosis? Thank God. He didn't ask enzymes in that. Which is the most dirty part of the game. Out of this, Sandhoff and Woolman are not sphingolipidosis. What is Sandhoff? Sandhoff is hexosaminidase A and B deficiency. Hence it is called gangliosidosis. Is what you need to basically remember. Then what is the sphingolipidosis? Gaucher's disease. What is the enzyme, doctor? Gaucher is GU. Glucose it is. GLU. Somebody to remember. Fabry. Fabry may A. Fabry. Phonetics. Alpha glucose it is. Galactose it is. Niemann-Pick is sphingomyelinase. Tay-Sachs. Remember TSH. H is? Hexosaminidase is what you need to remember. Fabry, 5 points that you should not forget for entrance exam. F is foam cells. A is angiokeratomas and alpha galactosidase deficiency. B is burning pain in extremities and BUN elevated. They also have renal failure. And it is a X-linked recessive. Y is there, no? So you will remember X, so X-linked recessive. This is also favorite MCQ in entrance. What is the pattern of inheritance of Fabry? X-linked recessive, and it is a sphingolipidosis is what you have to ultimately remember. Now doctor, Niemann-Pick disease is what? Sphingomyelinase. Fabry is alpha galactosidase A. Crab is galactocerebrosidase. Gaucher is glucocerebrosidase. Tay-Sachs is hexosaminidase. Metachromatic leukodystrophy is aryl sulfatase. ये तो ये गाना तो होना ही पड़ेगा एंट्रेंस के पहले कम से कम 3-4 बार. वन क्वेश्चन विल डेफिनेटली कम.